my name is Jessica Wells and I'm a solicitor in the employment department here at Thompson, Snell and Passmore, and I'm joined by Ben Stepney, a partner in our team. And today Ben and I are going to be discussing the impact of the four-day working week trial, the largest four-day working week trial in history, and we'll be discussing the kind of results of this and the impact that it has and will potentially have on employees and employers. So Ben, could you please just briefly explain the background of the four-day working week trial?
Yeah, this was one of the largest trials of a four-day working week that's taken place around the world. It took place in the UK from June to December in 2022, and it was supported by a campaign group who tried to promote the idea of a four-day working week. Mm. Just over 60 companies took part. They agreed to give it a try for 6 months, and this involved around 2,900 employees, and the companies involved varied. You had financial services firms, manufacturers, and a fish and chip shop as well. And the results were recently reported and got quite a bit of media coverage.
Okay, fantastic. So in terms of that report, what kind of outcomes and what were the sort of successes from that report?
Well, the headline figures were quite stark. 92% of the organisations involved said they would continue with the arrangements. Mm-hmm. Of those, so that's about 54 of the participants. Mm-hmm. Of those, 18 of them said they would implement it permanently, whereas the rest would continue with the trial. There was some concern about the bottom line, about whether it would affect profitability, mm-hmm. But overall, there was a slight increase in profitability reported. At the same time, many employees liked the concept of the four-day working week. They said that there was less feeling of burnout, mm-hmm. And employees said that they were less likely to consider leaving their employer.
Okay, so it sounds like something that's been really successful. With that success, presumably several or many employees and employers might want to implement that into their kind of companies. In terms of things to look out for and in terms of legal implications, what is there to look out for?
I think from the legal point of view, employers need to remember to start with that you can't unilaterally change an employee's contract. It needs to be done by agreement. Mm. Now, in some cases, you might think that an employee is being given a chance to work 4 days instead of five, but for the same pay, that they're unlikely to object to that. But there are some other issues that need to be ironed out concerning holidays. How do you deal with days holiday? How do you deal with bank holidays where they fall on the fifth day that you're no longer working? Mm-hmm. How do you deal with shifts? Does everybody have the same day off, mm-hmm. or is it varied? There'll be issues like that that need to be ironed out.
Okay, so it sounds like there's a lot of pros leaning towards the four-day working week. Are there any kind of cons that people should be aware of?
Well, I think people should bear in mind that the participants in the survey were self-selecting, mm-hmm. so they chose to take part in it.
Okay.
In the first place. Of those who took part but didn't continue with the trial, some reported that what happened was employees worked extra hard over those 4 days, mm-hmm. To the extent that they felt that they couldn't enjoy the extra day off because they were exhausted and mm-hmm. suffering from some burnout.
Okay.
4 days isn't going to work in some organisations, in some sectors, for example, possibly customer service facing, mm-hmm. call centre spring to mind, where it's either going to be detrimental to customer service, mm-hmm. or perhaps will result in increased costs as more staff have to be recruited to increase the workforce overall, or perhaps more overtime is offered. So I suppose I would say to an organisation who's thinking of trialling the four-day working mm-hmm. week is to make it clear in your documentation that it's a trial to start with, yep. and to reserve the right to revert to the previous arrangements.
Okay.
I mean, I do wonder that for those organisations who adopt the four-day working week for now, I wonder how long it will be until people are asking them about a three-day working week.
Yes, no, I'm sure. No, that's been really helpful. Thank you for sharing, Ben. So you heard Ben talk about the fact that there might be implications on employers and things that employers will need to look out for going forward with the four-day working week if it's something that they look to implement into their own companies. If you need any assistance or advice going forward, then please do feel free to reach out to the employment team here at Thompson, Snell and Passmore. And you can access that information on our website.